Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. So you read the title of the video. I am going to recommend your product. So before starting, I want to say this is not a sponsored video. And like, you know, you can shop these products from any website. There is no specific website I'm recommending. But if you do want to shop from Nykaa, then you can use the links in the description bar, because like I get a little commission out of it. But you can, you know, shop these products on whichever platform, you know, gets like gives you the best deal. It can be Purple, Myntra, Nykaa, Sephora, like anywhere, whichever gives you the best deal. Of course, go click, you know, take the product from there. But yeah, if you like want to use Nykaa, then you can use my you know, links in the description bar. And one more thing is, don't spend unnecessarily. I mean, I would not say this during a normal time, but we are in a global pandemic and we don't know when situation goes here and there, so be mindful when you spend money. I mean, I don't want to be a mom here, but you know, sometimes we go overboard, so be careful of that. And one more thing is that all the products which I'm going to recommend are like something which I've not recommended enough. So if you want like other product recommendations which I've done in the, like, you know, past, you can like check out the videos which I'll be linking here. That those products are really like, you know, still my favorites. It's just that I'm not going to repeat those things again and again because I've spoken about them multiple times. So I'm going to only concentrate on the products which I've like not mentioned a lot on my channel. And these products are like absolutely like products which I really, really love. I have no complaints whatsoever kind of products. I can give you 90% guarantee, like 10%, because you know, every skin type differs, but I can give you 90% guarantee that these things, you know, will work for everybody. I just want to say one last thing before starting. I don't want this intro to be too long, but if you're like, you know, me, who's a creator who started out or anything like that, then invest very wisely. Don't buy a foundation worth 3,000, instead buy 5-6 things in the price of 3,000, if that makes sense. So, you know, invest smartly. Like, of course, if you have the money, you want to splurge, you have a lot of things, and then you're looking like for something else, I have all the recommendations for you. So let's get started. And again, always like a disclaimer, please ignore my hair. Like, I didn't even have, you know, like I didn't even put efforts to style it. I just washed it and it's like, this is my air dried hair, guys. Like, look at this. I can, you know, try to like this video is not about that. So first product is I'm going to like not going like I'm not differentiating between drugstore and high-end. I'll just mix everything and show. First I'll just show makeup, and then in the end I'll show skincare. There are of course a lot of skincare products. These are products which most skin types can use, so I'm going to recommend such types of, like, you know, skincare ones. So I'm going to show the products which are like around me, the products which I don't have around me. I'll just put a picture here. It's just that they are like too far off and I don't want to like recap. Like, I have more than 30 products here, so I don't want to, like, you know, get everything and mess my whole setup. So the first one is MAC Fix Plus. Now I have the tiny one, but you can grab the bigger one. I have the bigger one as well, but this is something I really like. I just like transfer the bigger solution into this one every time. It's so small, so handy, I can carry it anywhere. This is one of my favorite. I have to use this before I start my makeup. I absolutely love it, and it does last a really long time. If you get the full version, I can guarantee it, if you use it once every day, it'll last for easily like you know, more than 3 to 6 months for sure. So this is a really good investment. It is expensive, but you know, of course, you're going to have offers. I think, you know, in most of the high end, you don't have, like, you know, extreme discounts, but you have complimentary gifts, which is amazing as well. Like, you know, MAC will have lipsticks or something like that. So this is one. And the next one is this foundation. This is the L'Oreal Infallible 24-Hour Fresh Wear. This foundation is an empty, okay? This is over. It's been like more than 10 days that it's over, and I feel so handicapped. Since the last 6 months, I got so used to reaching for this one every time, wherever I go, whatever I do, that it's over. And I'm like, I don't have that thing to use. I'm absolutely going to take, like, you know, buy this one during the sale. It's one of the best foundations in drugstore. It is a little pricey for a drugstore. Like, 1100 is not cheap, but I'm sure, you know, L'Oreal will have amazing deals, and you can grab it for you know, lesser price. Absolutely love this one. I think everybody should try this one. The next concealer I really like is this one from Flower Beauty. It is a little matte finish, but I love the finish it gives. I love the coverage it gives. I really like this one, and it is quite affordable. I think it's 700 or something. So I really like this one. If you're looking for a really like medium to full coverage concealer, which is not LA Girl, then you can definitely give this one a try. Next one, I don't know if this product is going to be on sale because it's a new launch, but this one is from Faye Beauty. This is their brush. It's like, you know, brows plus lash mascara. It's a really good, like, unique wand. Like, you have one side wand for brows, one side for mascara, like, you know, lashes. It's a really nice one. I really personally like the shade charcoal black, but they have three different types, and I really enjoy this one. You can check it out. I don't think this is available on Nykaa, but I will link their website if you want to check it out. It's like a two-in-one thing. Really nice, really useful. It doesn't give you that very full, like, clustered, voluminous lashes, but it's definitely buildable and very, like, natural looking, which I really like. Like, that's my wipe sometimes, and I really like my wipe for that. Or else it's always really good for your brows. It just gives that very nice feathery finish. Then next one is this bronzer. I've used this bronzer years ago, like I think easily 3 years ago, and then I never used it again. But I got my hands on this recently, and then I, like, you know, remembered why I love this so much. It's absolute beautiful. Now they have different shades, so that's really nice. This is like good for like medium deep. It's a very good warm color, very good bronzer, blends easily, looks like so beautiful. It's on my face right now, looks really nice. Then the next one, this highlighter just like took my heart away. This one is the Becca Champagne Pop. It is beautiful. The tone of the highlighter is so nice. It's a very champagne color, suitable literally for so many different skin types. Really beautiful, not chunky, gives a very nice, you know, glowy effect. I don't know how to explain that, but really good investment. Of course, you know, it is expensive, but it is worth it. The package is really cute, really tiny. You can put it in your purse wherever you want. Really love that one. The next one, these blushes I've been using since years. I absolutely really love them. I really recommend them to, like, literally so many people who ever ask, like, a good matte blush. I'm like Makeup Revolution. It is really nice. It's so, like, it's a proper matte not bronzer blush. I love matte blushes. It's just my vibe. I don't like shimmery blushes. I feel like it exaggerates my texture, but this one is absolutely nice. The tone is really nice. Like, you know, of course the color is the choice, but this and the Rose Kiss one, basically this is Coral Dream, that very like warm coral type of shade, and the other one I have is Rose, that's more pinkier, but really nice, really affordable, has good amount of pigment. It's not overly pigmented or underpigmented, same thing, but you know, I think this looks a little better than at least when it's open. The next one is the K Beauty powder. So previously in my drugstore recommendation, like full face of drugstore, I said that, you know, the shade is too light. So now I've got a new shade, which is Almond, and that, like, this one works very well for me under the eye, and I've been really liking this one. If you're looking for a really good loose powder in an affordable range and you don't like Maybelline Fit Me, then this one is really nice. This one is very less pigmented compared to the Maybelline one, which is something I really like, because I don't want my foundation concealer color to because I don't like my concealer and foundation color to change because of the powder, and the Maybelline one does that. So K-Beauty has like pigment, but it's compared to the Maybelline one, it's quite less, and I really like this. Next one, it's not makeup, but it's a perfume. So Estee Lauder sent me their Beautiful Belle mini version, and I am obsessed with that perfume. If there's a really good sale, I'm definitely going to purchase. Like, I was going to already purchase it, but I was like, you know, let's wait for the sale. What if it's like, you know, for a discounted price? It smells so good, you guys. I just hope that you guys don't buy it before me and then it's like out of stock. But it's really beautiful. If you're somebody who likes very subtle, like, feminine scents, you can definitely give this one like a try. It is so good. I'm not even kidding. I'm not a very, like, big smell, like, fragrance person, but this one like I just smell things, I'm like, yeah, it's good. But this one, I went like gaga over. I really like this one. Then the next one is the Tribe Concepts Body and Face Cleanser. I hope they have a Black Friday sale. I guess most of the brands do now. That's the reason, you know, I'm recommending. I'm not sure if all these are going to go on, you know, sale. But if they do, then you can definitely check this one out. So the Tribe Concepts Face and Body Cleanser, I absolutely really love, especially because it's winter. I really like using, like, you know, powder cleansers because they don't like dehydrate your skin, so they are very gentle. So like winter is the best time to use powder, so that, you know, if you're somebody who has like really dry skin, then obviously, you know, you should of course try powders, because very gentle, they don't like strip away the oil or anything, and they just cleanse, which are really really nice. I really like their Thylum also, but I've mentioned their Thylum so many times that I'll like, you know, I'm not gonna say that, but body cleanser, face cleanser, definitely would recommend. And the next one is the NYX Can't Stop Won't Stop Foundation. Absolutely love the foundation, love the finish, love the, you know, coverage. I really like everything. It's just that I have a wrong shade. I'm going to get a better shade during the sale because I have a shade which is way too dark. I have the shade golden, probably beige or something would be my shade, and I'm thinking I'll grab that one, hopefully if it's there in stock by the time I check it out. But really nice. That foundation is good in the terms of formulation as well. Like, it's really good for acne prone skin. Like, yeah, saying that, acne prone skin, there's one more foundation which is really good for acne prone skin, is like, that was like a drugstore recommendation, and this is high end. It's not that other foundations are not nice, but these are the two things I know. This is the MAC Studio Fix foundation, so I'm in the shade NC40. This is also a really good, like, in the high end, if you want to go high end, then this is a really good option for like acne prone skin. Love the finish of this foundation. It's medium to full coverage. NYX also is like medium to full. L'Oreal one, of course, like sheer, like medium, you can make it full, but that foundation looks very beautiful only like when it's like sheer to medium, that it gives that very nice skin like feel. That's what I absolutely love. Actually, you know what, because we are on the topic of foundation, there's one more foundation I would highly recommend, is the Smashbox Studio Skin. That foundation is so good, you guys. I mean, the finish it gives is so natural. Like, if you have really really pigmented skin, then you know, you will have to go in with a concealer to correct all that, and then you can go in with this foundation so that you'll get a more natural finish. But if you have like not so problematic skin and you're looking for some foundation which just like, you know, evens out like everything and gives you a like nice finish, then the Smashbox Studio Skin, best, like really really nice, affordable, not affordable but really nice. It's not affordable at any cost, but it's a really nice foundation. And then the next product is this one from Benefit. This is their Cakeless Concealer. I have it under my eyes right now. Really nice, medium to full coverage, more like full coverage, suitable for all the skin types. Absolutely love the finish, the coverage, the longevity, doesn't crease, doesn't move. So yeah, what more do you look for in a concealer? It has so many shades. You can shop it if you want it. Then the next one, now I don't know if Glomier Beauty like lashes is having a good sale, but I've been recently, like I recently bought 3 lashes from them and I really like them. I've used 2 other lashes from them before as well, like Divine and Soho. I didn't really like Soho, like that's a personal choice. I don't like lashes which are very thick at the band. I like lashes which are very thin at the band and like very fluffy. It's just like a personal preference. But recently I've bought Wild Child Expensive and Shameless, I believe, and I really love these lashes. They're really really nice. If you know they do have a sale, or if you're looking for really good lashes brand, other than Pack Cosmetics is like the brand. It is so affordable. The lashes are really beautiful as well, but of course, you know, they're not like all the styles like in the world are not available just on Pack, right? So I bought, you can like check these one out. The one I'm wearing right now is Expensive. I like it. Like, it's like thin in the starting, fluttery in the end, and it just gives a lot of drama to the eye. I really like it. Looks really nice. Fits. It just goes on really easily. Like, that's what I like about the lashes, that it just sits very well. I don't have to like have a lot of struggle. That's something I hate about few lashes, that it takes so much time to like sit. I don't like that. This one just goes on very easily. It takes me hardly 1 to 2 minutes to put it on, which I absolutely love. Then next ones which I'm going to recommend are not available in India, but if you're somebody who's looking to shop from the US, then you can definitely give these ones a try. Obviously, if you don't have, what I used to do, like at least from the past 2 years, it worked out for me that somebody comes down in December from like, you know, US to India because it's Christmas time. And so like, you know, right before Christmas is like Black Friday sale, right? So I shop it and like I ship it to them and they get it to India, and that works really beautifully for me. But if you don't even have somebody, it could kind of be like, you are paying, like you're getting discount, but you're paying shipping and customs, so you at least get the price product for its original price, if that makes any sense. Like if you would buy something for 3,000, then shipping is 4,000, then customs is like 1,000, then you get product for 5,000, right? But let's say you get it for 1,500 during the sale, and then you get like 1,000 shipping, 1,000 customs, then you get it for 3,500. I hope I'm making sense. But yeah, Black Friday is a really good time to shop from the US, especially because they have also super amazing deals. So the first one I would recommend is the The first one I would recommend is the Iconic London Eyeshadow Palette. So yeah, this one from Iconic London. This is their Day to Slay Eyeshadow Palette. I am recently obsessed with this palette. So many beautiful nudes, like I could create so many natural looks with this. Natural, smoky, glam, ultra glam, but in that neutral zone. If you're a beginner, you don't want to play with colors like I played right now on my hair, like, you know, face, and you're looking for a really good eyeshadow palette, then this one would be a really good one to grab. They have so many shades. They have pink tones, they have warm like orange tones, browns, like neutral browns, everything. So I absolutely really recommend this one. I don't know, like things like Jeffree Star's palette gets hyped, and this one is just like sideline, of course, like, you know, because there's no controversy. Anyway, one more is if you're like a makeup artist or basically a creator looking forward to creating really good colorful looks, then I would definitely recommend James Charles eyeshadow palette. Now I have the mini one, they have the big one, but I think, like, I mean, if you're just going to use one palette for all the time, then you can definitely grab the bigger one. But the smaller one I think is really nice. It's tiny, at least it fits in something. The bigger one, like the original one, is like really really bigger, so that's the reason I bought the mini. And the mini has a mirror as well, which is really nice, though I think the bigger one doesn't have the mirror. Now the other one I would really recommend for bright eyeshadows is the Beauty Bay Eye and Bright eyeshadow palette. Really good match. I just don't love the shimmer, so I would, like, you know, maybe suggest you just go with all the matte. So there's Beauty Bay Eye and Bright palette, and there's Beauty Bay Eye and Bright matte palette. So the matte one has just mattes of like those same colors, and the Beauty Bay normal like eye and bright palette has like mix of mattes and shimmers. The shimmers in that palette are not that great, but the colors are really, like, really really good. So maybe, like, you know, go for the matte palette so that you get a lot of like matte colors to play with. The next one I would really recommend is this one, Sua Beauty UV Taffies. Mine looks very ugly, but you know, these are really good neon liner like shadows. So if Sua Beauty has any good deal going on, then you can definitely grab these ones. They are so pigmented, so good, don't go on patchy, gives such a beautiful even application. I really really like this one. Then for eyeshadow palettes which are available in India, I would really recommend a Makeup Revolution palettes, the Reloaded palettes. The old palettes of Makeup Revolution are not that great, but the newer ones are really nice, and the things which they collab with people are really nice as well. I really like the Reloaded the Reloaded range of the palette, and I really like Nikha K. I cannot not mention those palettes. Really affordable. I don't know if it gets better than that. I got three palettes for $999, and you know, if there's even a better deal than that, then you can definitely grab those palettes because they are also really worth it. I really like the shades, they perform really well, they stay really well. Now finally, in the end, let's just go through skincare products. Now these skincare products are like skin type neutral, like oily, blah 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 blah. Now, oily skin person can use it, dry skin person can use it, but of course there's always going to be an exception, like everybody has different skin type. But I've picked up products which might suit most of the people, so if they don't suit don't come for me. So all the products which I'm going to mention are like fragrance free and all the nasty things free. So the first one we have is the Earth Rhythm Cleansing Gel. So they have come out with like makeup melting off balms. They already had one, but they have launched like the gel versions of it. And I must say, I really like, I've used the a thicker version of them, but I really like these gel ones to melt my makeup off. I've been using them for over a month and I really really enjoy them. They don't have fragrance, nothing of that sort. Like I already told you, Earth Rhythm had an issue of having alcohol in their products, which they don't have in this one. That is really amazing, and I really like this cleansing gel. So yeah, if you're looking for a good cleansing balm, cleansing gel, then you can give this one a try. It's a new launch from them, like I think it's been like a 2 months or something like that. And the next one is this Clinique Moisture Surge. This is a savior during winters. Any skin type can use, normal, dry, anybody. Absolutely, like really nice. I really like this moisturizer, works really well for me. Clinique is going to have a lot of offers. I mean, I cannot tell you yet, you can see in my stories, but wait on, like they'll have amazing offers. So not only this, they have like other things which are really amazing. Like they have a different, a mix of, you know, customized moisturizer. So you can like pick and choose according to your skin type. That is really nice from them. But this particular moisturizer, absolute favorite, really like, fragrance free, really nice. Then the next one is the Estee Lauder Night Serum. So this product, I always thought it is hyped, but I really like it, you guys. I mean, it works. I always thought like, you know what is there, but you know, if you just want one really nice serum to maintain your skin and like hydrate it, nourish it, then I think Estee Lauder Night Advanced Night Repair Serum is really nice. And the next one is the Organic Harvest Lip Balm. I've tried a lot of lip balms, trust me, I love lip balms, I've tried a lot of them, but that one is my absolute fave. It just creates a seal on the lips, it lasts for so long, it hydrates the lip. I go to many other like lip balms, I'm like, yeah, they're nice, but I always come to that one back. It's really really nice, a very good lip balm to buy. Then the next one is the Neutrogena Zinc Sunscreen. Now people often get confused when I tell the sunscreen a Neutrogena, they usually go by the blue one. Blue one is a chemical sunscreen which I don't like, it doesn't suit my skin at all. But the one I really like is this one. This is the yellow one. This is their Sheer Zinc Tri Touch sunscreen. This is my absolute favorite sunscreen. It does have a huge white cast, I'm going to warn you about that. But if you have sensitive skin, or if you just feel like no sunscreen absolutely suits you, then you should always, like, you know, definitely give this one a try. Non-comedogenic, fragrance free, really nice sunscreen. Like I don't really mind the white cast if it's going to, you know, protect my skin. I can like just add a little bit of makeup and remove the white cast if I want, but that works really well for me. So yeah, that sums up today's video. Please shop smartly. Comment below and let me know if you're interested in any of the products which I mentioned. I would be like interested to know which products you want to grab. And yeah, that sums up today's video. I always mean to say this, but I always forget. But today I remember that comment below, guys. It just helps my video to reach more people. You can just say hi, how are you, hi, thanks for the video or anything. Comment like if you really like enjoy the video, it does help me grow and reach more people. And yeah, anyways, that is today's video. I hope this was useful, and if you like the video, then make sure like, share and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye! Happy shopping!